Thanks for having my back out there.
I was annoyed. Honestly, I think the whole WWE universe was.
So, guess this means we're finally gonna get our match, huh?
You're pretty excited for someone who's about to get handled.
I see how it is. Well, you just go ahead and underestimate me, champ.
Oh, I don't underestimate you at all. I've seen your stuff on the indies. I know you can go, but so can I.
You've watched my indie matches? I didn't know you'd be into that.
What? Just because I started wrestling at WWE and never had an independent run doesn't mean I can't appreciate what you did there. I mean, that dive off the balcony against La Cangrejita Loca? Wild. Self-destructive and probably ill-advised, but wild.
Man, if you had ever been a free agent when I was in TBD, I would have gladly jumped off a balcony against you too.
That sounds like a blast. Except, I'm the one who would have been doing the jumping. Don't get me wrong, I'm happy with how it came up, but I do sometimes wonder what an indie career would have been like for me. It sounds like an adventure. What?
Just gets me thinking about our match.
About whether I'm going to pin or submit you?
No. Well, not exactly. Someone recently pointed out that I was lucky enough to experience a fantastical whirlwind tour when I got to WWE. I got to have the adventure. I'm wondering if I should pay it forward.
What do you have in mind?
You're confident you're gonna beat me anyway, right?
Anytime, any place.
I was really hoping you'd say that.
So yeah, welcome to another WWE 2K24 My Rise Unleashed Vidya, y'all. Your boy Jason JV here, continuing the story.
You want to do what?
It's just going to be two matches.
Best of three series. So yeah, it might go two. If Bianca really has no fight in her.
It'll probably go two. That's as many as I need.
It's not the best of three series that gives me pause. It's the locales. It is the usual custom to defend the WWE Women's World Championship on WWE TV.
Sure, we could do that if we want to stick with what's comfortable. Or, get this, we fight for the Women's World Championship in the coolest indie arenas around.
Japan? Mexico? We could even go back to your old stomping grounds in the UK. Honestly, sounds like a great way to push that grassroots international exposure you business types are always talking about.
And you know what else it sounds like?
Oh, I'm positive you'll tell me.
It sounds like a big swing. It sounds like taking advantage of every opportunity on the table. And it sounds like doing something different without being afraid to fail.
I know what you're getting at, and I'm not sure I like you turning my words back on me.
I'm sorry to interject, but this is ridiculous. It's unheard of. Allowing a WWE champion to defend at these underground indie shows? Untelevised? What about the advertisers?
Advertisers? Really?
I'm afraid Troy makes an excellent point. Marketing will hate this.
See?
Fortunately, this is not a marketing company. This is a professional wrestling company. A professional wrestling company that's going to take a swing, and whose general manager cannot wait to get on the road. The only question is, where to first?
Don't look at me. This is your world. I'm just the adventuring tourist who gets to hit you, wherever you so choose.
Let's see. We could face Bianca in the UK at Club UK, or we could face Bianca in Mexico at Lucha Magica.
I loved wrestling in Mexico, especially for this promotion called Lucha Magica. Sometimes they do shows in the middle of a town square. You're gonna love it. Except for when I beat you. That part'll suck. But the rest will be awesome.
This is gonna be so tough on your ego. Mexico sound good to you?
Alert the crew to get their passports, Troy. We're taking it international.
Let's go. Oh. She used her hair. That can't be legal. I'm pretty sure that's a weapon. Are you serious?
Dear, dear, dear. That cannot have gone as you'd hoped.
No. Everything went exactly according to my plan of getting hit in the face a bunch.
What?
Are you regretting giving Bianca the invitation into the Indies?
Not at all. I missed the intimacy of a smaller show. The interaction with the fans. Just didn't expect Bianca to pull the same energy from the crowd quite as easily as she did.
Bianca got very comfortable very quickly.
I would have hired her for TBD. It was beginner's luck.
If she had come up in the Indies, I would have wanted her for TBD. But that's not going to stop me from beating her at our next stop.
Which raises the question, where to next on this great tour of the world?
Let me see. Japan, LA. Been to both already.
Bianca played a little fast and loose with the rules out there. So at our next stop, let's lay down the law.
I'm sorry.
Law. L-A-W. The Los Angeles Wrestling Promotion. It was a pun.
And those are seconds of my life I shall never recover.
Wow.
The City of Angels it is.
And let me guess, we're gonna win this time, right? Yep. Woo! All right, Bianca, let's go. Ref, get out of the way! Damn, Jabron. No! I'm pretty sure I did not hit the run. Why are you lying? Bitch, get your shit out. Do this one move and it's taking me all this trouble just to get it. Shoot, attacked. No! There we go.
Ladies, it appears that you two we'll be going to a final match.
Fitting, really. Winning that championship will be even sweeter after going the full series.
Don't get cocky. No way you beating me twice in a row.
Before you two launch into a witty repartee, I have an update. I've just spoken to the suits in Stamford. They have thoughts.
Well, that's never good.
Word of your genuinely marvelous matches has spread, and so has the buzz. They were insistent that the next match will be on WWE television.
They want us to do the match on Raw? You promised us we could see this through in indie arenas.
Indeed I did, so I reached an agreement. We will be producing a portion of next week's Raw live from the location of your final match.
Oh. Ooh. Wow. Listen, I know this is a stretch, but how would you both feel about having the match at
TBD? Yes, a surprising and unexpected suggestion from you. which is why I have already given instructions for the road crew to meet us there.
Wow, it's gonna be super embarrassing to lose on your home turf, but I, for one, am here for it. One idea, though.
What's that?
With everything I know about TBD, and since it's the final match, kind of seems like it should be no DQ, right?
Bianca Belair, you have no idea what you just asked for. Deal. Geneva is gonna freak. Wow.
I'll second that wow. And raise you a hot damn.
They really got to work in here, didn't they? Can you believe it?
After the hectic morning I've had with the crew to get this set up, I can. Had to yell at some guy named Troy a lot. He kept wanting to cover up the TBD signage with Raw logos entirely.
Sounds like Troy. I'm really glad that I could do this for you, Geneva. For us. Did you ever imagine that we'd be here?
Honestly? You main eventing a TBD show feels pretty familiar to me. This one just has more logos.
You know what I mean? This is different. Later tonight, I'm gonna win the WWE Women's World Championship in the house we built.
Living the dream. Hey, you get ready. I've got some contracts to look at.
Same as always. But seriously, don't get too caught up in paperwork that you forget to enjoy yourself tonight. This is big. Big, big.
I know. It is. And I won't. But I also know you'll enjoy this enough for the both of us. Good luck out there.
She's gonna betray us. I can read it on her. So predictable.
The following is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the WWE Women's World Championship.
It's a TBD homecoming for the captain.
It looks like old school Raw, like early 90s Raw. When they're in the Manhattan Center. That's what that reminds me of.
Introducing the challenger from Las Vegas, Nevada, Bell Blackwell! And her opponent from Knoxville, Tennessee, the WWE Women's World Champion, Bianca Belair!
Let's go.
The referee letting our competitors take one final look at what this match will be all about.
Like how the side plates can still, you know, bend like they're made out of rubber.
World Championship.
It's the main event of WWE at TBD. The title is at stake as TBD Original Cap takes on Bianca Belair in a rubber match for the Women's World Championship.
A WWE title defended all over the world, and now at a U.S. indie promotion? I never would have believed it.
Well, watch out. Big miss right there. Oh, reversal catches Bianca.
Yeah, it's a rapid fire bionic elbows, and how about one more for good measure? Oh boy, that's a determined stare that's come across her face.
Oh, the spear.
Interceptor, Corey.
Oh. Oh, what a close line. Oh, that belly. The champ taking their share of hits now. She still has a lot of time to recover, though. Stomping the arm. Bianca is losing any remnants of control now.
Bianca needs to figure things out.
Oh, hell.
She's fighting back.
Bianca managing to get some control back now.
Maybe Belair's found a new source of aggression to battle back with.
you.
Disrupts the attack with an elbow to the gut.
Oh, okay.
Well placed elbow to break up the maneuver.
Nope.
Steered clear of that.
German suplex. And momentum's fading away from her. Yeah, she's having issues fighting back.
Spot buster. Just another insane display of power.
She slips outside. What has she got in mind?
Uh-oh. Clear the table.
Yeah, gonna take it to the next level.
What is this superstar thinking?
They're thinking about the end, finishing this thing off by any means necessary.
Everyone get out of the way. These two are abandoning all restraints.
No.
Oh, forget about pandering to the WWE Universe. That should keep her head in the game. Bianca is certainly fighting from behind now.
Bianca here in a disheartening position.
She'll take things into the ring.
And now she's looking to go top rope. Flying.
Oh!
Not exactly what she'd planned to have happen to her during this match, but she knows what kind of fight she's in now. That is, if she can remember where she is.
She should have had a plan for this, Corey. This has gotten way out of hand. The
no
WWE
table.
Universe.
We got wood.
They want tables. It looks like she's giving them what they want.
And back in the ring we go. Bianca Belair.
Shit, that was late.
So strong, so powerful. First the gorilla press. By Belair into the moonsault.
Where in the world does one find such strength at this stage to kick out that early in the count?
Goodness, that hurt the shoulder.
Big mistake. Told you.
She steers clear. And all that momentum comes to a screeching stop.
Do you stop being all grabby?
Off the hook, opponent trapped down with the powerbomb.
Crushing the hamstring.
Makes it incredibly difficult to walk.
Onto the table. Oh!
Vicious. She's about to rise up to something catastrophic. Bam. Super kick!
We can have a new champion.
Super kick!
She's bringing the table into play here.
Let's go.
She is done playing around. Power slam.
All right, hold on. I was trying to do this and this.
Getting carried around. Bad spot to be in.
Oh!
Good attempt for the championship.
Come on!
And just like that, this journey for the woman they call the captain reaches a conclusion with a victory over Bianca Belair.
Hey, this is no 70,000-seat stadium, but on this night, in this small theater, this audience feels like WrestleMania.
Well, there's nothing like WrestleMania, but I think it means a little bit more to this superstar that her first championship win happened here. A full circle moment, Corey. This woman has followed a long and winding road that brought her back to her beginning.
What's next for this superstar? This WWE champion? Woo. The sky's the limit.
What's Bayley doing here?
Bayley was the number one contender until she got injured after War Games.
Bayley's not moving like she's injured now. What does she want?
What do you think, Saxton?
No, 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 no. Not in my ring.
TBD promoter Geneva Rose is not having it.
Well, I guess she's ride or die with our new champion, but what's she gonna do to stop Bayley?
You got WWE problems. Go settle them on WWE time. Because believe me when I say, if anyone, anyone tries to interrupt my best friend's hard-won moment, it's gonna be me.
What?
No,
told y'all.
For years.
Don't trust anybody.
This
told y'all. Saw the writing on her face.
This is karma, Saxton. You can only step on so many people before you pay the piper.
And she's paying now, but for what?
Thanks for coming home, Cap. It was so generous for you to put this show together for me. I know you think I'm slumming it around here, but you forget that I'm proud of what we built together. And I know you're used to taking the credit for everything. So I thought it was important for me to make an appearance tonight, to set the record straight. You'd be nothing without me. Let me be clear. I am not just some best friend side character in your hero's journey. What do you think I've been doing since you left? Sitting around and just following your career with rapt attention? You moved on. I didn't. And I've been putting everything I have into growing TBD. So, when Bailey approached me, I was more than happy to help turn your moment into my moment.
You can feel the bitterness from Geneva Rose, the jealousy.
Recognize this? The contract we wrote in the diner when we first started TBD. Yeah, I had it framed. Thought it was a nice touch. Especially now. Because according to this legally binding document, you're still signed exclusively to TBD. You can't work anywhere else. You can't be champion anywhere else. And you belong to me.
But she's a WWE superstar.
Not according to Geneva Rose.
See you next week, Cap. Don't be late.
All right, so we got Club UK, Josie Japan, and Mexico Plaza unlocked.
Well, that didn't go quite like I thought it would.
No, it did not. What are we gonna do?
So, some bad news about that. Geneva sent a photo of the TBD contract to legal, and the napkin checks out.
But it's on a napkin!
A legally binding napkin. You're still signed to TBD. And as long as that's the case, you can neither be WWE Women's World Champion nor a WWE Superstar.
You're not serious.
Unfortunately, I am. The title will revert back to Bianca. Although now that she's healed, Bailey will have an opportunity next week.
See, we can fight this. This is unfair.
There's gotta be something we can do to fight this.
I wish there was, but my hands are tied. Good luck out there. It's been something.
Wow. All right, y'all. I think we're going to go ahead and call it a video here. Yeah, see, my girl's nodding in agreement because she needs her rest. But tune in next time as we will continue right from where we left off, as we always do. So, yeah. Appreciate y'all watching. And yeah, hopefully y'all are enjoying the series. If you are, y'all know what to do. If you're new here, do all the YouTube things. You know what I mean, whether you're new here or not, doesn't matter. Do all the YouTube things. Like, comment, share, and of course subscribe. You know what I mean? Help your boy out. That'd be greatly, greatly appreciated. Until next one, y'all have a blessed one. All right, peace.
Jason JV on YouTube.
What's up with you, Jason JV?
What up, Jason JV?
Just sending love, peace, and blessings to you.
JC, you are my homeboy, my guy. Don't call me guy, pal. Don't call me buddy, pal.
Much love to you, JV. Chris Calico. Cali, baby. Oh.
What's up, JV? My name is Jimmy Badass. I'm an athlete and I just do what I'm doing. Say what's up to me. Keep your motherfucking head up. I don't know why you're sad. If you're sad, she's
So subscribe, tap the little bell, turn on the notifications, and if you're not down with that, we got three words for you. Eat it. Yeah.